Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Marcus Aurelius, and this is Total War Attila, the Eastern Roman Empire, and History. And in the last episode, we discussed a little bit about the Emperor Theodosius I, and we had an incredible victory against the forces of Aksum, and now they are left pretty much defenseless in their city, and our army is on the march. Now, I forgot to improve their tradition, so we're going to do that. What I really want is integrity in foreign territory. So I will, next time they gain, I'll do that, because I also want ammunition and replenishment. I want everything, obviously. And there, I guess their emblem is the little sunflower, or whatever this is. It looks like the thing that Mario shoots fireballs with in the Mario games, but hey, whatever. It's good. And I may rename this legion after we conquer Aksum, something like the Conquerors of Aksum, or, I don't know, something cooler than that. Let me know what you think. Army withdrawn? Oh, right, yes. Yes, we did that on purpose. East Germanic separatists have raided our lands. Or not raided, but they've walked onto it. And the Ostrogoths and the Roxolanians are at peace. That is not a good thing. We certainly don't want our enemies to like each other. Alright, so here we are in Italy. And we are going to force march. But I didn't really want to walk all the way to Ravenna. I think the reason for this is because since this territory has been desolated, there are no ways to walk through it. But if we go all the way to Ravenna, we're putting ourselves basically at the mercy of the Roxolanians. Let's just go here on the mountains. I think they won't be able to go past Ravenna without attacking it. Don't know for sure, but we'll find out. If they do decide to attack us, they will find us well defended on a mountain hillside. Okay, you're just going to stay where you are. And we're going to go back to Bithynia, where we're going to build another local... Or should we build more agriculture? It's a good question. We have a full-scale wheat farm here, although the fertility in this province isn't exceptional. It might be worthwhile to build a sheep farm to get some extra money. This is a military wharf, so it's not going to do us any good. It just creates squalor, allows us to create boats. Which is good. I have to remember to recruit all my navies from Wikimedia, but I prefer the trade ports or the fishing ports. We can't improve. Let's see. All of our cities on the border have been improved, right? We have Marcianopolis level 2, yes. Viminacium level 2. Sirmium, of course, is looking good. Let's see what's going on in the east. Trapezus might be a good place to upgrade to level 2. And squalor in this province is okay. Amida, definitely a good place to upgrade, but we can't afford to anymore. We have our skirmishers here. Yeah, that's another reason to keep this place safe, is because it's our generation for good range troops. Our income is just so bad. So obviously the Huns are playing something out here with the East German separatists, and we might have to get involved here. In the meantime, let's get some Legio. Okay. And you're just our Syracuse people. You're basically garrison duty. That's all you're here for. So. And the Navy of Rufinus has already moved. Alright, I just want a quick check. So. Cilicia is going down in happiness due to a lack of sanitation. Alright, well, nothing I can do about that right now, but next turn I'm going to spend some money to increase this waterworks to a reservoir, which will include public order and sanitation. I think in all situations that's better than the latrines. I can build stuff here, just can't afford to. Maybe some industry, although I do have local industry here. So maybe industry here. And keep this one open for later options, we'll see. Everybody else is happy. Libya's going down a little bit. Why? Maybe squalor? Taxes and religious differences. Okay, Greek Christian. And paganism is big here. There is no church in Libya. And I know churches are expensive, but maybe a first level church would be a good idea just to solve the problem of religion. Characters minus one. There's no governor appointed, so I don't know who they'd be referring to. So it's going down one a turn. I don't think it's worth not taxing them. I think I'd rather just build a building that'll make them happy. Which in this case might have to be a little church. Or I could just make a little chapel in one of the villages. Maybe that'll be less expensive than an actual church in the city. That's probably for the best. Other than that, I can't see... Because they've got little lights coming down here. I don't know what that means exactly. Alright, that's fine. And obviously Ethiopia and this area is... Well, this one's getting better. But Ethiopia obviously is very unhappy. I don't blame them. So we'll just hope to make them happy in future turns. So one interesting religious fact about Theodosius is that he employed Goths, as we discussed, in his armies, and one of the things he did was he had a Gothic garrison of the city of Thessalonica, and the people of Thessalonica did not like this, and they rioted and they murdered the Gothic garrison commander. Theodosius, of course, was enraged, so what he did as a result is he had his Gothic troops massacre about 7,000 civilians in the hippodrome, or the racing area of Thessalonica. Now, emperors have done crazier shit than this in the past, and it wasn't a big deal, but now we're talking about the age of Christianity. So the influential bishop of Milan, a gentleman by the name of Ambrose, basically excommunicated the emperor and said, you just don't do that kind of thing in a Christian society. So he actually forced the emperor to do penance over a number of months, and finally then allowed Theodosius back into the fold of the Christian church once again. This was to set a precedent, because in the future, there will be a number of conflicts between emperors and patriarchs or popes, and even though those religious figures don't have any type of military strength or power, they wielded enough influence that, in many cases, the emperors had to bow to their will. So this was like the first time that happened, and it was just a sign of things to come. Okay, so what's happening here? Their incredible navy is attacking our little shitty navy. I don't even know why we have a navy. I don't even understand this. And our garrison, which hasn't even been built yet. I'm not even sure what I want to do here. We can't fight them, let's just be honest. They have measles and they have no soldiers. We're just going to lose this battle. And let's see what the Aksumites do. I doubt they're going to raise their own city to the ground. I highly doubt that. And I will not shed tears at the loss of a navy in a sea that I don't even want a navy. Nope. They're just sailing away.
We see little profit in further bloodshed. You have fought with honor. But it is time to storm.
Yes, absolutely. Give peace a chance. So Theodosius remained loyal throughout his career to Gratian and Valentinian II, at least while they were alive. And as times wore on, despite his loyalty, he became more and more powerful in his own right, because he was just a stronger man than they were. He was a better emperor. He was more experienced in military matters. So while he remained loyal to them, he also sort of, despite being the junior emperor, became the senior emperor. They sacked their own settlement. And rebellion is imminent. Due to the high demand for mercenaries in neighboring provinces, the cost of recruiting them has risen somewhat. Okay, he secured his office. Excellent. You're my guy against the Persians, eventually. Alright, so... yeah. Ethiopia is a mess. That's okay. They can rebel. I don't care. I'll take them out. We have our allies here to help us. But first, we're going to invest Aksum and take it down. Alright, so we don't have siege equipment, so we're going to have to build that. I'm just going to do the cheapest one so that I can storm the place next turn, probably automatically. Although it is telling me here that their strength is about equal to ours, which is crazy. Either way, let's get some ladders. Maybe a siege tower. Okay, it says 4 turns, but I'm not going to wait that long.
We take this settlement for Rome!
And of course we have him here. Let's actually move him back to this place. And make these people happy, if possible. Oh yeah, now they're only going down by 37. Okay, good. Alright. Okay, we're in the winter. Hopefully that's not going to hurt our guy in Italy. Greek Christian 47. Greek Christian 53. Up 12. And this place is... come on, help me out here. Up 1. No, we're going to have to move him back. And I guess he can't make them happy this turn. Alright, Rufinus, there's no way for you to get here. Otherwise, I'd send you here. Or is there? Can you go down? No. The Suez Canal has not been built yet, so Rufinus is actually kind of useless in this particular space. There's a navy of our friends, the Western Romans. Let's actually head Rufinus up here so that he can blockade Genoa while we attack it, because they do have a substantial number of troops, it looks like. Okay. I think it's best to get out of force march.
I'm afraid we cannot.
Oh, man. The Roxolanians are basically standing in our way. And we can't...
that is impossible.
Let's get closer to them, I guess.
Is that all?
Wish we could get around them, but we cannot. Nope, nope, nope. Stop! Damn it. We may just have to walk through this province. It might take a while, but we might just have to do it.
What does Rome require?
I don't really want to fight the Roxolanians just yet. Let's upgrade these guys. Well, now we have horse breeding too. Excellent. I haven't moved you around lately, have I? Luckily for us, you haven't received any bad traits. Arcadius is wintering in... Sirmium. I'm not going to move him out. You're doing your thing.
We hunger for battle.
Okay.
Beginning my journey for Rome. Your next command?
Yeah, this place is not doing great. We could upgrade to a bathhouse. It'll raise public order by 1. It's not great. Instability? Okay, that's going to lower, so that's fine. Religious differences? Yeah, there's no Greek Christian anything here. That's a problem. Immigrants and characters, really? They don't like our general?
What does Rome require of me?
Why? Doesn't really say. Let's see if we can give him something. Yes, public order plus 5. Exactly what I wanted. Okay. Theodosius was so loyal, actually, to the emperors in the West that he fought 2 civil wars on their behalf. One when Gratian was killed by a man named Magnus Maximus, which actually sounds like a great name for a condom brand, but he took him out when he murdered Gratian in 383. And then he left Valentinian II as the only remaining emperor in the West under the command of his Frankish general Arbogast. So, while Valentinian was nominally the emperor, Arbogast, who was answering to Theodosius, was in charge, really. But, as we discussed in our previous episode about the Goths and Alaric, Arbogast rebelled himself, and he... Well, we don't know what happened, but the Emperor Valentinian II died under mysterious circumstances, and Arbogast claimed that that was because he committed suicide. But in reality, Theodosius believed that he was murdered. So he marched west again, fought Arbogast and a pretender to the throne that he brought up by the name of Eugenius, and that took place on the Battle of the Frigidus River, which we discussed in detail in that episode. And that was in 394. Again, just to summarize, it was widely viewed as a victory of Theodosius and his new Christianity over the resurgence of the paganism of the Western armies under Eugenius and Arbogast. Oh, I see. I'm like, why am I allowed to participate in this battle? It's our allies. Let's just auto-resolve that. Oh, see? That's what I paid, whatever, $1.99 for, or however much the blood pack cost. Really? I get to choose this? Okay, just replenish, I guess. Knock yourself out. So he took out the rebels for us. And now the Roxolanians are running around. An unscrupulous rival has spread foul rumors. Okay, so Eutropius now, just like in history, is not getting along with my wife, Eudoxia. Wow, she's mean. So that means that his troops' integrity is down too. That sucks. So we can pay him off and lose influence, of which we have quite a bit. Or we can ignore him, which would give him the out-of-favor trait, but it would also cause us to lose 4% control. And I believe our control is already down a little bit, so we're just going to pay him off. I don't want to, but I guess control is important. I don't know. Our dominion is relatively low. Our control... Actually, our control is good. I could have sacrificed a bit of control. It's our power that I'm a bit worried about. We're balanced. So we have loyalty plus 2, but our tax rate is negative 1. So it might be a better idea to go up to respectable. Well, but that lowers public order. I think at balanced, we're good. What can I do? Can I somehow help Eudoxia at all? Seek support? Meh. Doesn't seem to be necessary. We can have a new military count. Are any of you guys not anything? Probinus? No, you're higher ranked. I wish they wouldn't do that. I wish if you had a guy that was already a higher rank that they didn't highlight the lower rank so that you can put him in there. Because that's just confusing. But at least it says down here what his job is. Imperial Master of Foot. Eutropius is nothing and he's going to be nothing. I'm kind of sick of him. You're Master of Soldiers. Soldiers, soldiers. You're nothing. And apparently you can't be anything. You're a military count. You're a count. Alright, so these guys who have one star can't be anything. So I guess Rufinus? Well, actually, you can't be anything either. Oh, because you're already a count. Okay, so nobody here, I guess, has what it takes to be a military count. Alright, well. So it goes. So it goes.
How can I serve Rome?
You're serving Rome by just keeping the people of here somewhat happy. Can we convert this yet? We cannot build. Oh, required technology. Oh, right, it's a level 3 city. That's a problem. I guess we didn't buy anything last turn because we have a ton of money now. That's a huge problem. Well, we'll move that anyway. And what's the fertility like here? I can't imagine it's very good. It says infertile. Yeah, okay. So I guess the best thing for us to do would be sheep in this instance. But yeah, it would give us zero additional food regardless of what we choose. So we'd either get 55 food from cattle. So wheat farms are worthless. The sheep would give us 40 food and a bunch of wealth. Let's do it. Sheep. Sheep all the way. Alright. Really, it's saying here this is gonna be just a slight victory. That really stinks. I wish it were higher. Because then I'd auto-resolve and feel confident doing so. Because, I hate to say it, but assaulting city battles are just terrible. They're just terrible and annoying and long. We're gonna wait one turn, I guess.
Laying siege to the settlement.
That's fine.
What do you wish of me?
I want you to make these people happy. And I want you to make these people happy. And I want you to get up here.
Moving out. Drop anchor.
Yeah, we're not at force march anymore. There are the Roxolanians, so we'll take this opportunity
march.
To get around them.
Ready for further orders. Ready for orders.
We are going to go back up to Bithynia. And we will do more industry. We'll upgrade Amida. Okay. Fishing jetties would probably be a good idea. What does this give us? Industrial and commercial buildings. So, we get commerce from fishing jetties, so that is technically commercial, I believe. I believe commerce and commercial go together, so that would work together in harmony. And industrial. Alright, we'll do fishing jetties for now. And if it makes the squalor bad, we'll upgrade to the reservoir. In fact, we were going to do that somewhere else, weren't we? Forgot, was that... No, where's the squalor bad? Was it Libya? No, Libya squalor's fine. Huh. Oh, here we go. Yeah, Cilicia. Shoot, and I spent all my money. Well, next turn. Alright, we're looking good again, and we can go out and shake our legs, get a little walk going on. I don't like the idea that Arcadius is just sitting around. I wish I could do something with him, but I'm not going to declare war on the Ostrogoths just cuz. Okay, you're waiting a turn. I want to also recruit more cavalry, but I'd rather spend the money improving my cities right now. We're not in too much danger. 2D Anus is just going to run around, although now at least Constantinople is protected with a reasonable force.
What does Rome require of me? Ready for battle.
And honestly, Sicily is really in no threat, but... And that was a mistake. They're not getting any worse, though. That's fine. I guess we can improve the fountain. That won't necessarily help us, though. See, I don't understand if... I guess the public order bonus of 1 would help, but not a ton, but it'll take us from 0 to 1, which should, in the long run, help. What we really need is a priest. Alright, next turn we'll see what's going on with Aksum. Actually, you know what? It looks like we are almost out of time anyway, so next turn we will discuss more about Theodosius, and we'll attack the city of Aksum some way or another. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, I am Marcus Aurelius, and this is Total War Attila, the Eastern Roman Empire, and History. Have a good one.